over the world, the amount of people diagnosed today as being somewhere on the autism spectrum is drastically rising. Today, people talk of numbers such as 1% up to 3% of the general population as being autistic. The fact that many people are being diagnosed today as autistic has made autism to be a hot topic for scientific research. This means that autism is not only investigated by psychologists today, it is also studied by scientists from a multitude of fields that attempt to find out what causes autism and explain unique autistic traits. When conducting their research, scientists believe that autism is a real thing. In other words, they assume that autism is more than just a name that was given one day to a bunch of behaviors. They think it is an actual physiological or mental disorder that was affecting people way before it was discovered. This brings scientists to ask questions such as, what kind of thing is autism? Is it something in the mind, in the brain, in our genes? What makes autism different than other disorders? They make many studies and investigate many physiological and psychological findings in order to answer these questions in a clear way. However, although autism has been under the microscope for so many years, scientists today still don't have a clear answer to these questions. Psychologists find it hard to say which behaviors are actually autistic and which are not. Biologists and geneticists have not yet found one physiological or genetic cause for autism and have not yet been able to explain its prevalence outside of a specific family. Taking this into account, as well as the fact that so many people are diagnosed today as being autistic, one can understand why it is still very important to scientifically investigate its origin and effect on people.